Hi everybody, today I'm going to show you how to clean your injectors on your clean water store model 7500 rev 2.5 control valve. So this particular valve is an air valve. It's set up with an air check valve. If you were cleaning the injectors out for your softener or whatnot, this would be where your brine line is. One thing you do want to do, the air valve doesn't require a filter, but your softener will have this little filter installed in your brine line. Make sure that gets cleaned out and you rinse that off too. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and remove these just for the ease because this unit's going to come off. So I'm going to go ahead and remove the drain line and that. And you can certainly leave it hooked up if you have your system all installed. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to remove these two screws. Be careful when you remove these because, like I said, this whole unit's going to come loose. And there are some small O-rings behind there you want to make sure you don't lose. So we'll go ahead and remove this unit. These are the three O-rings that I'm talking about. They seat on these three bosses here. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to remove this cover. So you have the cover and the O-ring. And here you see this is going to be your injector nozzle. So we're going to unscrew this. That's what that little guy looks like. You can see there's a tapered hole through there. Then the injector throat is down inside. Again, just unthread this. And that's what your injector throat looks like. Again, you can see there's a hole through there you need to have cleaned out. So what you can do is you can soak these in like a white vinegar, citric acid possibly, but white vinegar works really well. Go ahead and rinse these out, soak them, get them all cleaned up. Also, you want to make sure your port in here is nice and cleaned out. Once you do all that, clean them up, you can reinstall them. I do want to mention when you reinstall this throat, it's a small plastic part. You can break off this real easy, so you really want to be careful when you're screwing it back in. And a matter of fact, here in the shop, I don't even grab the handle of the screwdriver. I just go until it stops, just snug it right up like that. Okay, then you're going to reinstall the nozzle. Again, this is a big screwdriver because there's a large area here. But you don't need to over-tighten it. These are plastic parts, so just snug it up. Okay. Now you're going to take your cover, and you're going to slide your O-ring so it fits like that. This will only go on one way. If you're 180 out, it won't line up. So what I like to do is go ahead and get that guy snapped into place. Use a little 100% silicon food grade lube on there if you need to. And then you just want to hold this up here and line all your ports up nice, and it'll snap right into place. And then I just kind of hold it into place till I snug the first screw in. You want to make sure you're up in there good. You don't want to be binding and pinch those O-rings in there because you'll create leaks. And just go ahead and snug those up, and then go ahead and I'm going to put the air injection check valve back in, but also your brine line you can plug back in, and then also your drain line you can thread back on there. And that's how you clean the injectors on a 7500 rev 2.5. Thanks.